Vabbè, oggi facciamo un po' di miscellane, un po' di varie cose. Cominciamo innanzitutto a parlare anche un pochettino di matrici complesse. Il libro che vi ho dato di riferimento, il Salce, la trasposta coniugata la chiama AH e dice che una matrice, quella che spesso e volentieri voi la trovate spesso con Astar, trasposta coniugata, giusto? Quello, una cosa che è importante è introdurre il concetto di matrice normale. La matrice A C n per n si dice normale se sono serie per definizione AH uguale a H. Ok? Allora, perché sono importanti queste matrici normali? Allora, vediamo qualche caso di matrice. Allora, questa deve, allora, facciamo il caso per esempio Rn per n, in quel caso A trasposto deve essere uguale a trasposto A, quindi vuol dire che la matrice deve commutare con la propria trasposta. Allora, ci sono tante matrici che possono soddisfare questa condizione, per esempio le matrici simmetriche. Se la matrice è simmetrica, a trasposto uguale a è comoda, ma anche le matrici ortogonali. Le matrici ortogonali non hanno detto che siano simmetriche, perché chi è in quel caso la trasposta? È lì, è una matrice la sua inversa, comoda. Quindi questa qua comprende sia le matrici simmetriche che le matrici ortogonali nel caso reale. Nel caso complesso comprende sia le matrici, quantomeno comprende sia le matrici ermitiane, perché A uguale a star ad A, ma comprende anche le matrici unitarie, che in quel caso A star è uguale a H è uguale a meno 1, e quindi anche in quel caso comune. E ovviamente non sono le uniche a commutare, non è che sono solo queste, ce ne stanno anche altre, perché per esempio prendo una matrice unitaria, la moltiplico con una costante per 5, quella quando vado a fare H non è immersa, perché è tutto moltiplicato per 5, quando vado a moltiplicare per immersa mi verrà 25, la matrice volta, la matrice unitaria, però anche quella commuta con la propria trasposta coniugata. È chiaro? Ok. Quindi perché è importante questa definizione? Perché possiamo andare a vedere che il teorema A è normale, diciamo A complessa n per n è normale se solo se esiste U tale che UH è uguale a U a meno 1, cioè unitaria, tale che UHAU è uguale a una matrice diagonale. Ok? Cioè quando l'andate a praticamente bisogna usare il lemma di Schur. Quando voi andate a triangolare con il lemma di Schur, se la matrice è normale, invece che triangolare vi viene diagonale. Quindi questo qua è un'estensione del teorema spettrale. Allora, dimostrazione, questa è la vera condizione, che se solo se non di diagonalizzabilità in generale, ma di diagonalizzabilità con matrici unitarie. Okay. Supponiamo che A sia normale. Allora noi sappiamo che esiste un'unitaria, tale che noi sappiamo che UHAU, questa è triangolare superiore. Ok? Tuttavia andiamo a fare TH. Questo è UH per AH per U. E questa matrice è triangolare inferiore. Questa matrice è triangolare superiore. Trasposta coniugata sono gli operatori si applicano da destra verso sinistra, quindi qua fa trasposto coniugato di questo, qua trasposto coniugato di questo e trasposto coniugato di questo, è fatto due volte. Adesso andiamo a fare THP. Questo qua fa UHAU. Allora questo si cancella perché la matrice unitaria, quindi UA è la più in mezzo, e questo mi diventa UHAU. Andiamo a fare TTH. Questo cosa mi viene? Mi viene UHAU. UHAU. Quindi qua mi viene UHAU. Però questi sono uguali perché U è uguale, UH è uguale, questa è comoda e quindi sono uguali. Ok? Quindi io che cosa ho ottenuto? Facciamo un esempio in 2x2. Facciamolo con. Prendiamo una matrice triangolare inferiore per una matrice triangolare superiore. Ok? La facciamo A, B, C, D. Quello è TH, quindi in questo caso è la trasposta, quindi A, C, D, D. Allora, mettiamo che questa era triangolare inferiore, allora questa qua è triangolare superiore. Ok? Però lo faccio nell'esempio perché tanto una volta capito il concetto non serve una dimostrazione. Posso farlo pure al contrario. A C 0 D per A 0 D C viene A quadro più CB, poi viene C quadro, poi viene D quadro e poi viene andiamo a uguagliare TH e T, andiamo a vedere i membri sulla diagonale, scopriamo subito che gli elementi fuori dalla diagonale sono pari a 0. Quindi vuol dire, affinché questi siano uguali, vuol dire che in origine la matrice T non era triangolare superiore, ma era diagonale. Provate, questo è un utile esercizio, provate a farlo per esercizio, poi se non ci riuscite nella vostra prossima volta lo faccio. Va bene? Ok, I repeat. We want to show that if A is normal, normal means that A commutes with the AH, AH is this complex. Okay. Then we want to show that if A is normal, we are proving this error of the implication. There exists a unitary matrix such that UHAU is diagonal. So this means that A can be diagonalized using unitary matrix. Matrices. So what I put, this we know by Schultz lemma. This is upper triangular. Then we take the conjugated and transpose, and it's this one. Then we compute these products. Okay. And we find that this product is this one, this product is this one, these are equal, but these are equal also because they come in. So up to here everything is fine. Now I just made one example. I just assert that from this equality we can show very easily that T is diagonal. Remember that T is up to triangle. Okay. So already T, you already know that there's something here and here, simply. And I want to show that there is zero also above. Okay? And how I can show it? I told, try to do it by exercise. I just, in order to, like a hint for the exercise, I looked at the case, just real case, 2x2 matrices. If I
the terms on the diagonal, you will find that you will get that the sum of the square of the modulus of the entries outside the diagonal will be zero. And so if this sum of the diagonal, I don't remember exactly, but do the exercise, and, but it's like this, will be in some place the sum of the squares of the modulus, the moduli of the terms outside the diagonal. For example, I will, let us take the first row. When you have transpose conjugate, you have the first column. This is W. This is W transpose conjugated. When you, the first element on the diagonal is this one. Okay? C11. This row. Transpose. The matrix like this. This is T. This is TH. Okay? Take just the first element, C11. You have to multiply this row by this column. So you will obtain the square of the normal W. Okay? W1, W1 conjugated, plus W2, W2 conjugated, and so on. This is the norm in the Hermitian problem, standard Hermitian. But if you will compute TH, what is TH? TH is W1, the first element, WN, and here you have all zeros, and here you have other things. But when you transpose this, you have W1, WN, and all zeros here. So let us compute the first element. This is W1. This is sum for J equal to 1 to N W1J WJ modulus. This is W1, WN. Okay? But this is W1 modulus square. When you multiply this by this, then you get all this zero, all this zero. And then, comparing, you will see that this is the sum of squares of moduli. This term that is also here, the other terms there are not. So, in order to be zero, they are all non-negative numbers, they are all to be zeros. And then you will find that in the first row, beside the first element, you have zeros. Then repeat for, now you know that this is zero. Then you repeat for the second C22 and so on. Simple exercise. Okay? We have also to prove the commerce in the other implication. So we just proved that if A is normal, then this is diagonal. That now proof, we assume there exists U unitary then this means that A is equal to U D UH, multiplied by U on the left and UH on the right. And what is AH? It is U D deconjugated U. You have to apply the H to this matrix and it will go away. The H to this matrix means just conjugated because it's diagonal, so transposition does not take place. And then let us say D is diagonal. This is D11, DNN, zeros. D conjugated D. Conjugated, I conjugate every other because these are complex. I don't know if they are real, if D is real. So what is this matrix? This is this matrix, D11 modulus squared, DNN modulus squared, 0, 0. These two matrices they commute. Okay? Then let us compute AAH. This is U, D, UH, U, D conjugated, UH. AH, A is U, D conjugated, UH, U, D, UH. This cancels out, and then you have D, D conjugated, D conjugated, D. They are equal, and so they are equal. And so you got that A is not. So this is just if and only if. If you know that A is normal, then you can use some unitary matrix, and then you get the matrix B diagonal by that transformation. Vice versa, if you know that you used some unitary matrix and you got here the diagonal matrix, then A. And I repeat, this definition includes Hermitian matrices, unitary matrices, and some other matrices. Normally, it's not. Okay? So this is one thing, just to know. It's one good thing to know. Okay. Then, now we cancel stuff. What is a householder matrix?
take a vector W in Rn. Our vectors are always vertical.
So actually when I want to write a horizontal vector, I have to put transpose.
I can do, I can perform two multiplication with this vector. I can perform
W transpose or W transpose W.
So tell me, where is this? This is in
where this belongs to.
This is n times 1,
n by 1.
So the transpose is 1 by n,
one
n by n by n.
And this one.
Householder matrix
HW is the identity matrix minus 2 times W transpose W.
This is just a scalar product of W, square normal W. Okay? Now, Remember that the vector W is not. If it is null vector, it is still this direction. But if vector W is not, if W was null vector, was not possible because here we are on the denominator, we are square norm. What happens now? This is W, and what is this?
W.
2W without this minus. So W minus 2W is minus W. So every vector V in Rn. If you remember Gramsci, the projections, this can be written like V plus V minus this. So this is U. This is lambda W. Of course, matrix is linear, so if you multiply by lambda W, you get lambda W, minus lambda W. Okay? Nothing changes. So, what will be HW applied to V? If you compute, U is orthogonal to W. So this will, U, HW of U will be U minus lambda W. V was U plus lambda W. When you apply H householder matrix to V, U doesn't change the projection along W flips, changes sign. Okay? And so this is interesting matrix. So if I take HW squared what I get? We will make one example. What we get? What do we get? Let us think like operator. Apply to any vector. Apply HW two times. What happens? No. You will get the same vector. Because U does not change. Never. The part with U doesn't change. If you apply two times, it's still U. But the other lambda W, first time it flips minus lambda W. Second time it flips again plus lambda W. So what does it mean? Who is this matrix?
Identity.
So which is the determinant of HW? Which is the term of, so HW is symmetric matrix, because if you perform transpose, they were just the same. This is scalar, does not change. This is transpose of this is W transpose. This is symmetric matrix. This is symmetric matrix. The sum is symmetric. So this is symmetric. The square is the identity. We are in Rn. So the determinant of Hw how much is it? Is it? By the theorem of Binet, the square of the determinant should be and so either plus 1 or minus 1. But in this case it is clear that it's not how much is it? Plus 1 or minus 1?
Minus
1. Why? Look.
Minus lambda.
This minus lambda. Behold, why? You can. This is hyperplane. This is W. That goes in minus W. This flips when you apply H. All other vectors here, they are not changed by the matrix. So you find this is n minus 1 hyperplane. You find the base of n minus 1 orthogonal vectors here. And then you complete the base with the last vector, W. Then you apply the matrix and what do you obtain? The same vectors. This means that with respect to this base, the matrix is 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and just the last is minus 1. So this is a flip matrix. If you move this base, you will get just the flip of the last coordinate every time. Okay? And this is a useful matrix. It can be used for make several constructions. Okay? This is called householder matrix. Okay.
So they can name this household.
If I am not mistaken, it's like this.
I can check. Holder, but householder, because the name was householder, was not Helder. It's Helder, there is mathematician, but it's another. I have to find it. Yes, householder. Here is Italian book is written without the 2 points, but I think the 2 points are there. I'm not sure about the 2 points, but usually if it's German name should be with 2 points either O E. If it's American name, I don't know, maybe the 2 points were taken away. But this is just not a mathematical problem. Okay? We can make one example, just in order to let us take W1 equal to 1, 2. So, W is equal 1, 2. So, HW is 1, 0, 0, 1 minus 1, 2, 2, 1, 5.
This is scalar product.
Yes.
let us make the computation.
And this is 1001 minus 1/5 of 1224. So this is 1/5 of 5 minus 1 is 4, then we have minus 2, and then we have 1.
So we are in R2. In R2, an orthogonal vector to W, U orthogonal, is 2 minus 1. Let us say that we have V is equal to 3, 2 minus 1 plus 6, 1, 2. What is this? 6 plus 6 is 12. Minus 3 plus 12 is 9. So HW of V, let us compute by the theory. This should be 3, 2 minus 1 minus 6, 1, 2. Remember, this does not change and this flips. And so this is 6 minus 6 is 0, minus 3 minus 12 is minus 15. Let us try. We have 1/5 for minus 2, 1, times 12, 9. So we have 1/5, 48 minus 18 is 30. Then we have minus 24 plus 9 minus 15, so we have 6 minus 3. So we made mistakes somewhere.
Yeah,
HW is 1, 1, 1, 0, 0.
minus 1, 6. So this is identity minus 1/3, 1, 2, minus 1, 2, 4, minus 2, minus 1, minus 2, plus 1. So 3 minus 1, this is 1/3. 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 minus 4 is minus 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. Then you have minus 2 plus 1. Minus 2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2. This is the minus. So let us take. Here we have the vectors orthogonal to this one are there are two independent vectors orthogonal to this one. Let us take one vector, for example, 3, 1, 5. 3 plus 2 minus 5 is 0. So let us take 4, 3, 1, 5 plus 3. 1, 2 minus 1. This is 12 plus 3 is 15. 4 plus 6 is 10. 20 minus 3 is 17. So, by theory, if I take this vector, h double of, let us call v this vector, this should be 4, 3, 1, 5, minus 3, 1, 2, minus 1. So it should be 12 minus 3 is 9, 4 minus 6 is minus 2, 20 plus 3 is 23. Let us try. Multiply this by 15, 10, 17. 30 minus 20 is 10, plus 17 is 27, divided by 3 is 9. Minus 30, minus 10 is minus 40, plus 17 is 54, 18, no. 40, minus 30, minus 40, plus 34 is minus 6, divided by 3 is minus 2, 15, plus 20 is 35, plus 34 is 69, divided by 3 is 20. I'm using the words. Okay? So, it is a simple scheme. You have this vector W. You build this matrix, apply to some vector V. By Gram-Schmidt, this vector V can be projected along W, some component along W, and some component orthogonal to W. Then, this component, the orthogonal component to W is not affected by the application of the matrix, and the component orthogonal to along W is flipped. The coefficient is changed sign. Okay? Okay. 5 minutes break.